Good morning, all of you. Myself, Harsh Rai, I'm from India. I have completed my graduation in pharmacy discipline from India only. I have completed my M.Pharm, Master in Pharmacy, post graduation in pharmacy discipline from India only. And right now, I'm doing a PhD from India Endeavor. Professionally, I'm working as an assistant professor in Degree Pharmacy College. And part-time, I'm working as an Obey to Slim Clinic, which is a chain of clinics in our Gujarat state, who is managing overweight and obese persons there. In next slide, I'm going to small biography regarding myself. This is my born and school life, small villages. In Gujarat state, this is my graduation college. This one is my college where I am doing a job. I am working as assistant professor. This one is my clinic. Now, I am going to give you a brief introduction regarding my research work. In my post-graduation, I have prepared one formulation. The name of S-omeprazole buccalpaiz drug delivery system, which is used for gastroesophagus reflux disease, which almost I will present in a month of June in Chicago, gastroenterology. In my PhD, right now I am doing my PhD with the project title Modified Pulsing Gap Drug Delivery System, which is used for rheumatic arthritis. And I am project guide for a post-graduation student that metformin can be used as an anti-obesity medicine. So, right now I am not going to explain you regarding this my project work, but I am explaining my presentation that in our clinic, how obese person, what is the program is involved in our clinic for obese and overweight patient, how we are treating them. So, first one, we are starting from the obesity, brief introduction regarding obesity. What is obesity? Some of what happened, we are forgot the basic definitions of small words, basic words. So, obesity is a defined as an excess of accumulation of body fat inside our body. In India, over 90 million people were suffering from obesity. And in my state, in Gujarat, 70.5 million people were suffering from obesity right now. In classification of obesity, there are two classes of people who are suffering from obesity. Number one is an apple shape, second one is a pear shape. Apple shape can be known as, these are a synonym, android shape and center shape. And pear shape is a peripheral obesity. These are the synonym of this kind of obesity. Now what happened in this android shape? The body fat is distributed in different part of body, likewise upper trunk, chest and abdominal, which giving the typical apple shape. And in pear shape, the fat is distributed mainly on the lower trunk, hips and thigh, giving the typical pear shape to the patient. Now this kind of shape is mostly found in a male and this kind of shape is mostly found in a female. Now, these are the methods which are used for measurement of obesity. Upper one is a cheaper and inexpensive method. Downward is the expensive methods. Waist circumferences, hip circumferences, body mass index, skin fold thickness using capillaries, triceps, spatula, easily. And second one is the expensive method, underwater weighing, bioelectric imperialism, and computerized topology, topography. Now, we all know that what is the body mass index. This is the ratio of weight in kilogram. In India, we are using unit kilogram, liters, we are not using gallon, pound, we are using this kind of unit. And unit of this BMI is a kilogram per meter square. Now, this is a WHO classification of BMI. If the person has a BMI 18.5 to 24.9, that is called normal person. If the BMI is 25 to 29.9, this is called overweight. Then obese, likewise severe obese and morbidly obese if the BMI is greater than 40. Now this is also one more method for consider the patient is obese, overweight, and likewise morbidly obese. For example, the person height is 1.55 meters, so it can be considered as underweight if his weight is belong to here, 57.50. If the person height is 1.7, it can be overweight if his weight is 69.85. So likewise with the height, the capacity of healthy weight is going to increase. Now, how obesity can occur in a patient? The energy value of food expressed in calories. So, obesity can occur when a person consumes more diet, more calories in his or body when it needs, and excess calories are stored as a fat and lead to a weight increase. Now, what are the factors which are responsible for obesity? genetic factors, socio-economic factors, which means lifestyle, diet, cultural factors, psychological, hormonal, likewise medical factors. In genetic factors, we have done one survey that the adults who were adopted as a children have a weight closer to their biological parents as compared to the adoptive parents. In diet, increase in consumption of energy of dense food containing animal fats. Decreased consumption of complex carbohydrate and fibers cause grain, fruit. Likewise, increased intake of alcohol, salt, this all kind of diet can increase the body weight. The growth of fast food industries has made an abundance of high-fat, inexpensive meals widely available, resulting in a shift in staple foods from low-quality staples to high-quality refined staples. Another factor is the exercise or lack of physical activity. Urbanization and economic development in the Western world have a lead influence of lifestyle which is included less physical activity. For example, the car driving to work and school instead of walking and cycling. We are using TV, computer games, long hours sitting watching, energy time saving devices and machines, washing machine, reduce manual labor in the home. Another one is the socio-economic factors. The poor people who are daily going to struggling for a food, who are fighting for a food, what they have to eat in the evening time, they don't know. Now, poor families tend to eat energy-dense convenience foods. Often they have no alternative as they tend to low-cost foods. And people from lower socio-economics participate less in sports or physical activities in general. However, the lower weight control awareness, they are not at all aware with the physical awareness what they have to eat for a nutrition. They don't know. They just you can see here picture. Now, psychological, medical, and hormonal problem. Psychological factors are known as influence of eating habits. Many people eat in response to negative emotions such as anger, sadness, boredom. And metabolic and organic factors including drug therapies have been associated with this obesity. Next one is the cultural factors. The Japanese sumo wrestlers are well known as the obese individual. This is the cultural factor. He want to be an obese person. So they achieve their big size from an elaborate rice-based diet, fat-rich food and lots of sleep. Now what is the effect of obesity in our life? Which kind of disease can be occur with the obesity? Heart disease, high blood pressure, diabetes, cancer, gallbladder disease, osteoarthritis, gout, breathing problems such as sleep apnea and asthma. Now this is regarding our clinic. We have three key persons in our clinic, that is I am a pharmacist, one more is a physician is there, one is a homeopathic doctor is there, and one is a dietitian is there. So patient weight loss program will be under a physician's care, balanced education, appetite management and activity to lose weight. We learn them the strategies to keep weight off using the real food. And this is not a quick fix, this is a lifestyle change. These are six main tools for our program. Medical, motivational, physical, and nutritional. In physical, Obeto Screen Place consists of expert in fitness. We are providing trainers to their home and wellness who provide diet chart, education, and resources to help you incorporate fitness into your life, including physical activity is a critical part of long-term weight maintenance. We give to a patient the tools that they need to incorporate exercise into their wellness program. Nutritional, the Obeto Slim Clinics program was designed as is continuously evolving under the direct supervision of registered and licensed physician and dietitian. Our program provides patients the education tool to resources to make healthy food choices. And our goal is to teach strategy to patient for a long-term weight loss and optimal wellness so that they have tools to maintain it. And why our program need to choose to the patient? We help more than 3,000 obese and overweight patients for achieving their weight reduction goals. Our resources center provides weight loss tips, recipes, and fitness advice. Our homeopathic-based medicine products are specially designed by doctors and dietitians. And we are fastest growing medical weight loss program with 9 different locations across the Gujarat state. These are the examples. We have patients of our clinic who have first 110 kg weight. After our program, they gain 86 kg weight. Okay, that's it. Thank you.
Okay. So, The question for Dr. Shah.
Wanted to ask you what your experiences were with metformin. You mentioned it in your abstract, and I just wondered.
Yeah, metformin is there. Actually, I was researching for that project only. Metformin can be used as anti-obesity medicine because I have found some evidence regarding that metformin that metformin never create a hypodiabetic. Diabetes cannot be decreased by metformin. Metformin is only. I don't have done research right now, so that's why I didn't explain in detail regarding that much. But the research work is going on for that metformin that can be used as anti-obesity medicine. So I'm doing the research work regarding this one, this topic, this project, this one. Okay, thank you. Thanks a lot.